morning, Master Ichabod Crane sat at his desk and presided over the class of Sleepy Hollow children at hard work on their studies. He was in deep thought, and the room was silent and still due to a recent disciplinary action. However, this mood was about to be interrupted by a messenger from the Van Tessel farm burst through the doorway of the modest schoolhouse. He brought news of a party that would take place at Van Tessel later that evening. Once the messenger had left in a hurry to spread his message to the rest of Sleepy Hollow, the attitude of the schoolhouse changed at once. The once easily distracted children became extremely focused and rushed through their studies in anticipation for the party. School ended up being dismissed 1 hour ahead of
the party. Ichabod Crane spent extra time focusing on his outwardly appearance for hopes of winning Katrina Van Tassel favor once and for all. He spent an extra half an hour at the sink brushing his locks and arranging his rusty black suit so it fit just right. Ichabod also went to the pains to borrow a horse from Hans Vast Van Riper, the current farmer in which he was lodged with. The gallant steed in which he ran off on was Christian Gunpowder for the devilish nature. Although he was gaunt and shag and old and broken, Gunpowder was a spitfire, so off rode the pair of gangly Ichabod on his one-eyed horse. Along the way, the knightly scent was a sight to see, with Ichabod wearing short stirrups and having his knee up to the saddle pommels, he bounced the whole way to the house of the beloved Katrina, contemplating the wealth and good fortune that Mary her would bring.
Find that Brom Bones, the opposing candidate for Katrina Van Tassel's hand in marriage, arrived. He, of course, arrived on his great brood of a horse, Daredevil, who was every bit as vicious as his master.
Ichabod, however, was preoccupied with some other business. Upon entering the Van Tassel parlor, he witnessed the heavenly treats laid out for the guests. The aroma of the baked goods was more than he could handle, and he did justice to each and every last one of them. While indulging in the great feast, Ichabod pondered how he could have it if it was him living the life of this great wealth, and he decided he'd never associate with the sort that he does now. Meanwhile, Baltus Van Tessel, the father of the adored Katrina, was making